You can create your very own augmented reality game using just an iPhone. Want to know how? This video is for you. Hi, my name is Ryan Kopinski, and today I will show you how to create your very own augmented reality game without writing a single line of code and using just an iPhone. So let's get started. What you'll need is an iPhone and an app called Reality Composer. Reality Composer is an app made by Apple that is free to download for your iPhone, iPad, and Mac. In this case, we're using it on iPhone. When you open up Reality Composer and create a new project, you're presented with a screen saying choose an anchor. An anchor is a way to attach augmented reality content to the physical world. And so every AR experience needs an anchor. In this case, you have a variety of anchors that you can choose from. A horizontal anchor, a vertical anchor, image, face, or object anchor. We're creating a game of bowling. And in this case, we're gonna use a horizontal surface to lay out a set of pins and then throw a bowling ball at those pins. And so we'll be using a horizontal anchor. So when you tap on the horizontal anchor, a new scene is created and it comes with default content that we don't need. So we're gonna delete it. We're gonna tap on the cube, tap on it again, and then select delete. And then the same thing for the default text. Now, if this is your first time using Reality Composer, I highly recommend you watch my basics video that I'll link up here and in the description below. In this video, I assume that you have some experience with Reality Composer. And so the first thing we're gonna do is lay out our game. We need bowling pins and a bowling ball. And so to add content to our scene, we're gonna tap the plus icon. And that opens up our content library. And this is all free content that Apple provides to us in Reality Composer. So we're gonna scroll down and look for a bowling pin. There we go. When you tap on it, the bowling pin gets added to the scene. If this is your first time using the app, you may see a cube and a loading icon. This means that the content is being downloaded. So just wait a few seconds and then you should see the bowling pin. Now, if you want to change the way something looks in the scene, you do it in the Object Inspector. And so we're going to tap on the bowling pin and then select the Object Inspector. Here you can see the transform, which is the position, the rotation or the orientation, and the scale. What we want to do for now is just look at the styling of it. You have a stylized pin, you have an iconic, and then you have realistic. I really love the way the realistic looks. It even has like the dirt and like the shine. It is just beautiful. And so we're gonna use the realistic bowling pin. Now, since we're playing a game of bowling, these pins have to behave in a physically realistic way, which means we have to enable physics for these pins. And so you can do that by selecting participates and then selecting the motion type as dynamic. Now, I'm not gonna go into too much detail between fixed and dynamic motion types. For now, just assume that you're using dynamic. But this enables the pin to actually behave in a physics simulation, which is needed for any game. And so that's all we have to do for the bowling pin. So we can close our object inspector. Now, the next thing we have to do is add our bowling ball. And so we're gonna again tap on the plus icon and now select our bowling ball. As you can see, it's being placed right next to our pin, and it looks actually really awesome, but we're also gonna make this a realistic bowling ball. And so when we select that and close our object inspector, we see that it's like a beautiful shine to it, and it looks really realistic. We're gonna open up the object inspector again, because now we wanna again enable our physics for the bowling ball, because when we throw the bowling ball, we want it to react and collide with our pins. And so we're gonna select participate and again, select dynamic. And that's all we have to do for a bowling ball. Now, when you have a game of bowling, you have the ball in front of it and then you have a few pins. I believe the number of pins is 10. In this case, we'll just add a few just to show you how to create the game. But you should be free to experiment, do whatever you feel is needed to make your bowling game the best game ever. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna use our positional transforms, these cones, to drag and position the ball in place. I'm gonna try and center it in front of the bowling pin. But to do it accurately, what you really want to do is use the object inspector with the transforms. So I want to position the bowling ball 2 meters in front of the bowling pin. And so I'm going to set it to 200 centimeters on the Z axis, which is 2 meters. And then we're going to do return, and you'll see that the bowling ball now is 2 meters in front of the bowling pin. We're also going to center it in the X direction, and so we're going to set that to zero in the X axis. And so now we have our bowling ball positioned right in front of our bowling pin. Now, if you've ever played bowling, there's more than one pin, so we're going to actually create more of them. You can add them from the content library, or you can select the bowling pin and select duplicate. This is much easier because it already duplicates also the physics and the look. And so we're just going to position these. Now, you should take your time to position your bowling pins as well. So I'm just going to do that right now. Create a few pins just so we can simulate a cool game. Okay. And so while I'm doing this, if you haven't subscribed already, please consider subscribing. I really enjoy making these videos, and it is very encouraging to, you know, to see that you are enjoying it as well. So if you're enjoying the videos and they're helpful, please consider subscribing. I really appreciate it. Okay, and so now we have our arrangement. So you may notice that it's a little bit difficult to interact with the scene on an iPhone just because how small the screen actually is. It's actually much easier to use this app on an iPad or a Mac, but I just wanted to show you that, you know, you can be on the metro or the train going home and literally make your own augmented reality game, which is mind-blowing to me. And so that's why I did it on the iPhone. Okay, so now we have our pins and our bowling ball. So yay if you have that too. What I also want to add is a reset button, because when you throw the ball, if you want to play again, you need to be able to reset the game. And so that's what we're going to do. I'm going to tap on the plus icon. And in this case, we're just going to select a very primitive shape. In this case, a cylinder. We're going to move the cylinder out of the game space. Just put it to the side. And then we're going to do some editing of it. So we're going to make it a plastic material, and then for the color, what I want to do is make it red. Because when you press reset, you know, you want to show the user, hey, you don't just want to press this button because it's going to reset your game. Okay, and then the final thing that we have to do for the layout is the text. I want to add some text that says reset. That way your player knows, oh, this will reset my game. So we're going to position it right in front of the button, and we're going to edit the text to say reset. Okay, let's change that to reset. Great. And so we're going to, oops. Okay, now just to show you how these transforms work. So you saw how the circles turn from blue, green, and now red. So those are used to rotate it. And so when you see the red circle like that, if you drag on it, you can see that it's positioning it. It's rotating about that axis, the Z axis, I believe. And so now we have it at 30 degrees. And I think that looks pretty good. Great. Okay, so in just a few minutes, we were able to lay out our content for our game. Now, any game usually has actions or behaviors where you have to program and you have to write a lot of software for it. But I'm going to show you how to do the behaviors without writing a single line of code. So let's do that. To access the behaviors, what we're going to do is we're going to select more options, which is the icon with the three dots in the top right corner. And then we're going to select behaviors. As you can see, there's no behavior currently because this was a new scene. And so we're going to create our very first behavior. Now, remember this, any behavior needs two things, a trigger and an action. You can have one trigger only, but you can have multiple actions. In this game, I'm only going to show you one of each. And so there's many triggers you can use. Tap and flip, tap and play sound, and these are all pre-programmed behaviors. But I'm going to show you how to create your very own behavior using a custom behavior. Feel free to actually play with the other triggers. It's really fascinating to see what comes built in into this app. And so when we have our custom behavior, what we're gonna do next is select our trigger. When you select a trigger, there is a tab, so you can activate your behavior by tapping on an object. You can activate your behavior by when the scene starts or when the game starts, when the proximity to cameras, or when your phone is close to the object that it affects, or when it's colliding. In this case, we're gonna keep it simple and just select tap. Now, when I select a tap, you see a yellow dot. Keep that in mind, we're gonna come back to that. For the ball to actually move, what we're gonna do is we're gonna add force. And so we're gonna select our force action. And now you see a message saying select the affected objects for the add force action. And we see the same yellow dot under the action icon. This is because we haven't really told Reality Composer which object we want to apply a force to. And so when you select an object that you actually want to be affected, it becomes green in highlight. And you also now see one object. We only want the ball to have the force action, so we're gonna select done. And now that we select done and we've selected which object is affected, you see an arrow with some dots next to it. This shows the direction of the force. Now, when you play bowling, you don't wanna throw it up, you wanna throw it forward. And so we're gonna drag the arrow, I'm just dragging it using my thumb, and drag it down so it's facing forward. And then we're also gonna update the speed to 40 kilometers an hour. Now that's probably really fast, but I mean, this is augmented reality. We can do whatever we want. I think it's gonna be fun to see how fast it can go. But we're not done yet. And the reason why we're not done is because we still have a yellow dot on our tap trigger icon. And so when we select that, we get the same message that we don't have any objects selected to trigger the behavior. And so again, we're gonna select our ball. So whenever if you were to run this and the ball doesn't move, check back to your triggers and your actions to see that you've selected the affected objects that you need to select. And now we're gonna say done. So then we have that. Now, when we go back to our behaviors list, we just have the name behavior. We wanna organize our scene and our behaviors in a way that makes sense for other people if you collaborate with them. And so we're gonna press and hold our behavior, and now you see more options. We're gonna select rename and enter in throw ball. So this is our throw ball behavior. Okay. And the only thing that's left to do is actually to program our reset button, because we wanna reset our scene. So if you throw the ball and you wanna play again, then you press the reset button. And so we're gonna again create a new behavior, do custom, and then again a tap trigger, and we're gonna do... So there isn't really a action that just resets the scene, but we're gonna hack it. We're gonna use change scene as the action, and what this does, this usually is used for changing between scenes in your AR experience. But when you select the same scene that you were in, it resets to its original state, which means it resets our game. And so that's what we're gonna use as a trick. So we're gonna select our scene. There's only one scene in this case. So we have our scene selected. Now we don't have a yellow dot in the action, but we have one in our trigger. And so we're gonna select the reset text and the reset button. So now you see affected objects has two objects. And we're gonna select done. So we have no yellow warnings anymore. And so our game now is really done. So to test it in the simulator, all you have to do is press play in the top bar. And now you're presented with this, just the game. And when I tap on the ball, you can see it shoots to the bowling pins, and we don't have a strike, but it was really cool to see it actually hit the bowling pins. Now, if you wanna play again, because it is just so much fun, then you press reset. And we're back to the beginning and the pins are reset. And so we're gonna press it again and hit it. Now, we also wanna test it in augmented reality. So I'm gonna show you a demo of how it works in augmented reality. Feel free to experiment with it and make this your own, add more stuff to it. But yeah, this is really fun. And so to test it in AR mode, we're gonna tap on the AR button. Now you can see the pins and the ball laid out in my office. Now, to play the actual game, you press play, and then you tap on the bowling ball, and it just shoots against the pins, and it is really awesome. You can reset the game to play it again, and just tap on the ball, and then shoot it again. And that's how simple it is to create your very own augmented reality game in a matter of minutes, without writing any code, and using just your iPhone. I hope I inspired you to create your very own AR game. And if this video was helpful to you, I would really appreciate you giving it a like. If you have any questions, leave a comment below and subscribe to see more videos like these.